in een gelikte ambiance en met veel publieke belangstelling. Dit alles is gerealiseerd door een groep Haarlemse honkbalgekken voor Love of the Game. Ik ben onbeschrijfelijk trots en dankbaar dat ik daar leiding aan heb mogen geven en hier nu mag staan. Ik vraag het, dames en heren, één keer voor al diegenen die ontzettend hard hebben gewerkt om dit mogelijk te maken, één keer een daverend applaus. Now to the teams. To the teams coming from all over the world, I would like to say, on behalf of all Dutch baseball fans, welcome to Haarlem. Welcome Italy, Cuba, Curaçao. Welcome Japan, USA, and the Netherlands. We appreciate it very much. We appreciate it very much that you chose to participate in our tournament. And we will do our best to make your stay as pleasant as possible. However, on the field, you will have to do this yourself, together with the umpires. The umpires. So, teams. So go out and play hard and may the best team win. I thank you.
Dankjewel Guus. We gaan gelijk door, we gaan direct verder. We gaan over naar waar jullie allemaal voor zijn gekomen vandaag en dat is de wedstrijd. Voordat wij die kunnen gaan beginnen, gaan wij eerst de scheidsrechters verwelkomen. We gaan de line-up doen en daarna gaan wij ook over naar de volksliederen gezongen door twee speciale mensen. Daarvoor kom ik zo meteen bij jullie terug om die te introduceren. Maar eerst de umpires en de line-ups van de beide teams.
Ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to introduce you to the Italian team. Please give a big hand, batting first. Blake Seckler, we're going to start with the coaches. The coaches are Robert Kramer. Come on out, Robert. Robert. Gianmarco Faroni. Mariano Bindi. Alberto Doria. Michele Girardi. Thanks guys. All right, now the lineup for Italy. Playing second base, batting first, Riccardo Paolini. The Italian catcher, designated hitter, batting seventh, welcome Dario Bisano. Shortstop, batting number eight, Eric Epifano. Batting ninth, playing third base, Leonardo Farini. And the Italian pitcher for today, Christian Scafidi. And bring out all the other players, guys, so we can see who you are. Come on all out, everybody else. Thank you. A big applause for the Italian team.
Tjerk Smeets en Robin van Doornspeek. Dan de line-up als eerste aanslag met rug nummer 50. Midvelder Roger Bernardina. Tweede man aanslag, aangewezen slagman, rug nummer 4. Coco! Rug nummer 15, tweede honkman, Charlotte Schoop. Als vierde aanslag, rug nummer 25, rechtsvelder, Denzel Richardson. Vijfde man aanslag, rug nummer 13, eerste honkman, Jurelie Provar. Als vijfde aan, of zesde aanslag, met de rug nummer 5. Korte stop, John Polonius. Als zevende aanslag, druk nummer 21, catcher Tashenko Ricardo. Als achtste aanslag, met de druk nummer 12, linksvelder Giandito. Met rug nummer 22, derde honkman, Kevin Josefina. En starten Verpel bij de Kingdom of the Netherlands met rug nummer 16, Lars Kuijer. Please line up the rest of the team of the Kingdom of the Netherlands. Ik wil u verzoeken om te gaan staan. Please remove your caps, your hats and everything that's on your head. Graag uw aandacht voor het volkslied van Italië. Live gebracht door Carla Genchi. nu graag uw aandacht voor het Nederlandse volkslied. Zingt u mee uit volle borst? Het volkslied zal live ook gezongen worden door Johnny Lemay.
Wilhelmus van Nassau, ben ik van Duitse bloed. Mijn vaderland getrouw, blijf ik tot in den dood. De prinsen van Oranje ben ik vrij onverveerd. De koning van Spanje heb ik altijd geëerd.
Dank u wel, Carla en Johnny.
Welcome, everybody, to Game 2 of Honkbalweek Haarlem 2022, the European Baseball Classic, you could call this. Team Kingdom of the Netherlands versus Team Italia, Team Italy, as we are watching both managers exchange lineup cards at home plate. I should mention that the official manager for Team Italy is not here.
Bij de tweede hop Roy van der Wateringen. Bij de derde hop Jeffrey Benson.
Of course, Mike Piazza is normally the manager for Team Italy. He is still in the United States for Keith Hernandez's number retirement ceremony in New York with the Mets. So he will be coming in tomorrow. As we are looking at the umpires explaining the ground rules to both managers. Of course, in the orange for Team Kingdom, Evert-Jan Uthoen, the by now longtime head coach of the Dutch national baseball team, the Kingdom team, as we like to call it. You saw the introduction of all players of both teams, and as Metallica's Enter Sandman is crashing through the PA system here. We are getting ready for baseball as we are looking at the managers now, shaking hands with the umpires. Everyone is in agreement. It's a good night for baseball. It's actually a beautiful night for baseball here in Haarlem, the Netherlands. Slight breeze coming in from left field, left to right. The left-handed pull hitters will have a fantastic night tonight if they are able to get the ball in the air. And as we see this beautiful, almost synchronized way that the umpires run out into the outfield before splitting off, one to the left, one to the right, one stays in the middle. We are getting ready for baseball here in Haarlem in an almost sold out inner section of the ballpark. Only seats available in the bleachers in left and right. It's looking like a very promising night here in Haarlem. If you're wondering where my co-announcer from earlier today, Freek van der Kooi is, he's currently busy at work. He is also part of the social media and media team for the Dutch Baseball Federation, so he is currently hard at work in the dugout, shooting video of the Kingdom team. He might join us later, but I also might have a special treat for you later, in the sense that Sepp Visser, the chief media officer for the Kingdom team, has promised to potentially join the broadcast for an inning or two, just to say hi and talk to you about this Kingdom team. As we see starting pitcher Lars Heuer warming up, and you can see it beautifully in the left field on our brand new scoreboard. You can actually read the scoreboard in the video feed. That's new. Solid atmosphere here in Haarlem. Some last minute roster changes for Italy, where a few jersey numbers were altered, which means that the leadoff hitter will play with number 5 and not with the originally listed number 19, if you were so aggressive to download all the lineups and rosters from the Honkbalweek website, then you may have seen a wrong jersey number. And Guus van Dee, the chairman of the board for Honkbalweek, takes the field with a microphone. Let's listen in what he has to say.
Ik ben blij dat ik mag aankondigen dat wethouder Eva de Raad, alderman Eva de Raad from the City of Haarlem, wethouder Eva de Raad gaat de eerste bal gooien. De gemeente Haarlem was een enorme steun voor ons.
Guus van Dee saying that alderman of the City of Haarlem with sports, involved with sports, will throw the first pitch today. And we are thanking the City of Haarlem for once again helping Honkbalweek Haarlem become already a major success, and we're only one game into the tournament.
Good, thank you, Eva de Raad. First pitch, we are ready to play baseball. Is everybody ready? Leading off for Italy is Roger Bernardina. Sorry. Ricardo Paolini.
We're just about ready for baseball. Ricardo Paolini is taking his spot in the batter's box. For those of you who joined us earlier today for the opening game between Japan and Curaçao, we had some audio sync issues with the stream. We still haven't quite resolved those, but we have found a way where I will not be spoiling what is happening for you later on in the broadcast. We're underway. Lars Heyer has taken the ball and has started this game off. We are 2 balls and a strike to Paolini. And Paolini grounds it into center field for a single, which you will now see a replay of.
That brings up Vito Frisio.
There it is, up the middle, grounder for Ricardo Paolini, and a quick first blood draw by the Italians. And that brings up Frisia, who will attempt to get the Italians on the board early. An 86 mile an hour fastball from Lars Heyer will be coming your way shortly, right there. As we are working through some technical difficulties here, as you can probably tell, I'll just let you enjoy the game for a second while we try to hash those out.
We stick with a full count, one man on. Almost a stolen base, but it was a ball four. We got two men on, no outs. And that brings up Minio Alberto, catcher. Foul ball for Albert. Infield hit, safe all around. That means that bases are loaded, no outs. Up comes the fourth hitter, Renzo Martini.
Welcome back in Harlem. I hope you have been enjoying the footage we've been sending your way while we are hashing out some continued sync issues with our audio. As you can tell, Italy has the bases loaded, and we have Martini Parilli, the hitter, in the batter's box right now for Italy. And Heyer is struggling to get the ball over the plate, struggling to make the Italians swing and miss. He is ahead 2-0 now to Martini Parilli. And as much as I'm trying not to spoil anything, you can hear from the sound that's coming in through my headphones that we will have a run scoring play because Lorenzo Martini Parilli hits a sacrifice fly to center field. Runners from second and third move up one base, and that means Italy is up 1-0 against the Netherlands. And Heyer's got some work to do. Lars Heyer is having a fantastic season in the Hoofdklasse in the Dutch Major Leagues. He's pitching for Haasewe this year, who are in first place and cannot seem to lose. Heyer is their ace, and he has been spectacular so far this year. He needs to get out of this jam, though, because Italy still have people on the bases. Runners on first and third. Noel Gonzalez, one of several players on the Italian team who were born outside of Italy, who is facing higher now with a no ball, one strike count. Taking his time, stepping back, making sure that his batting gloves are fit correctly. And the pitch by higher, swing and a miss. That's strike two to Noel Gonzalez. There are so many signs coming in from the third base coaching box now that we have a slight delay in the game, because it's as if he's signing the entire alphabet to Noel Gonzalez in the batter's box. He's reading a book. And as you can tell, it's not going to help.
Up comes Rodrigo Celi playing midfield. One ball, two strikes, two men on, two outs. Top of the first inning. And that makes three outs. We head into the bottom of the first inning after two hits, scoring one run. Italy leads 1-0. It's a beautiful day for baseball here in downtown Harlem. I'm going to pass you over to the other announcer tonight.
While Italian starter Christian Scafidi, who was one of two players who changed his jersey number, he changed it to number 42. I wonder if there is a Jackie Robinson connection there, perhaps. Because you don't see many players wear number 42 anymore in the U.S., obviously. In Major League Baseball, number 42 was retired. Pop quiz question for you guys at home. Who was the last player in Major League Baseball to wear number 42? You'll get 10 seconds to think about it. And indeed, it was New York Yankees closer extraordinaire Mariano Rivera, who was wearing it at the time when the jersey number was retired, and he was allowed to keep it until his own retirement. And with that, he was the last player to wear number 42, except, of course, once a year in Major League Baseball when Jackie Robinson Day rolls around. And while we are still trying to figure out what we can possibly do with our audio not syncing up and me not wanting to spoil anything, you will see a fly out to left field now. And what is very interesting is the man who will come up to bat now for Kingdom of the Netherlands. He is famous around the world because he played professionally in the United States, but he grew to like absolute fame in Japan. The home run king of Nippon Baseball, NPB, Vladimir Coco Ballantyne, has returned to the Kingdom team. Even though he is officially retired from at least club play, he is more than willing to suit up for the Kingdom team and mash some baseballs out of a ballpark. We watched the Kingdom team take batting practice earlier today on one of the backfields, and it looks like Vladimir Ballantyne has never left. He was pounding the baseball left and right, and it was a joy to watch. He's facing Christian Scafidi.
Two balls, one strike on Coco.
Scafidi, born in the United States, went to college in the United States, pitched there, and is currently both pitching and working in baseball, as his LinkedIn page told me earlier today.
Two strikes.
Mm-hmm. to cover up the sound of what you already know will be a bass hit coming up right now. I can tell you that Christian Scafidi is throwing an interesting pitch mix so far today. That last pitch that was hit into right field was a hanging slider, 83 miles an hour. And I'm also trying to gauge for you Scafidi's fastball velocity, because we had some fans approach us earlier today in the press box asking why we did not have the fastball speeds or any pitch speeds on the new scoreboard. I told them the same thing I told you guys earlier today in the first game of the tournament. Unfortunately, our speed gun broke a few days ago. We ordered a new one, and that is currently not compatible with our setup here. We're hoping to get it fixed sometime this week, but I'm not holding my breath. So I'm peeking over the shoulder of Jacob of Synergy Sports, who's sitting in front of me and has his own speed gun set up. Hoping to gauge some pitch speeds. I saw an 88 mile an hour heater earlier. Though I'm wondering if Scafidi is holding back. Leaving some gas in the tank, so to speak, as we see many pitchers do. Don't blow all your bullets in one go. As Denzel Richardson has stepped in to the batter's box, and as you can tell, he has a three ball, no strike count. Denzel Richardson, one of the more dangerous hitters in the Dutch lineup, in the Kingdom lineup. Plays for LND Amsterdam in the Dutch Hoofdklasse, the Dutch Major League, where he is consistently one of the top performers in batting. Multiple MVP award winners, including last season, best hitter of the Dutch League. One of the best, if not the best, from Philipsburg St. Martin. And has established himself as a fixture in the Dutch League and the Dutch baseball world, with his infectious smile and joyous approach to baseball. Right now he's got a 3-2 count, and he is awaiting for the payoff pitch here from Scafidi, as you can see. And that is inside, that's ball four. So with two away, we have runners on first and second for Kingdom. And Jeremy Profar steps into the box. Profar, who played professionally in the United States for a while, is currently a free agent, looking for a club to play for. Played some minor league ball, played some indie ball in the United States, and has now come to Haarlem to suit up for the orange team you see on your screen. Scafidi is struggling to find a rhythm now. He's really taking his time. No pitch clock here in Haarlem just yet. As you know, perhaps you don't, because maybe you just tuned in now for the first time, we have 7-inning games during this tournament. 7 innings, not 9. In an attempt to fit in with the WBSC international rules that to speed the game up, we're shortening them by 2 innings. 7-inning matchups, which also means that we'll have games, our days with 3 games on the same day later on this week, for instance on Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, and Thursday, I believe. Which means that the first game would start at noon already, so get your breakfast beers ready. Profar fouls it off, stays alive. 0-2 is the count. Crowd's getting into it. We've got a nice full stadium. People having fun. And Scafidi once again really taking his time. He is not a patient worker. He is definitely someone who likes to think about the pitch he just threw for several minutes before throwing another one. Maybe he's contemplating world peace, curing world hunger. as Profar now has a one ball, two strike count.
Well hit, five foul ball. Two balls, two strikes, two out, two men on, bottom of the first inning.
So to give you a little bit of a technical insight into some of the issues we're encountering, the current camera you're looking at, which is the center field view camera, which is our brand new HD camera, which we're super happy with, this one is basically on par with what's happening on the field. Like, the difference is maybe a second, and this is by far our best angle. The problem is, if we show you the game through this camera from inning one through inning seven, you will not see anything but the batter, the pitcher, and whoever's running from second base. For some reason, we cannot get our other cameras to catch up with the center field camera, or for that matter, get the center field camera slowed down to a point that it's synced up with the other three or four cameras we have hanging around the stadium. That's just to give you an idea of what we're struggling with right now and why you're not hearing me talk as much as I would like to. I'm anxiously trying to fix any issues. As you see, Profar hit the ball way into right field. And I'll tell you right now, that ball rolls all the way to the wall. And two runs cross the plate for Team Kingdom. Denzel Richardson scores as the tail runner. And here you can see a slight replay, which I guess works. So Profar smacks the ball into right field. It rolls past the right fielder of Italy all the way to the wall. And Kingdom of the Netherlands takes a 2-1 lead. We have a stadium announcer who thinks he's the play-by-play guy, so you might hear an echo. And the Italian pitching coach is coming out to have a discussion with Scafidi. I wonder if one of the things they want to talk about is the fact that he's taking forever in between pitches. Might be good advice to tell him, hey, maybe just take the ball and throw it and don't think about it too much. Because obviously he's facing a very, very competent Kingdom lineup. And we see John Polonius in the on-deck circle, who plays for Curaçao Neptunus in Rotterdam, one of the best teams in Dutch baseball. Where he plays shortstop and multiple other positions, but mostly shortstop. Born in Willemstad, Curaçao, as many players for the Kingdom team are. I already mentioned Denzel Richardson, born in St. Martin. Several players from Aruba on the team as well, as well as some Dutch-born players who played either in the Dutch league or elsewhere. Players spread out across the world. Germany, United States, Japan. There's Kingdom players all over the world. Blink and you'll miss them. As indeed it does appear that Scafidi has picked up the pace a little bit, taking less time in between pitches. And as you can see, that's a pop-up to right field. Polonius not happy with it. That's out number three. But the Kingdom team scores twice and is currently in the lead 2-1 as we head to the second inning.
eerste helft. Tweede inning op het werpen van Lars Huijer, openingsstafman voor Italië. Korte stop met rug nummer 13, Eric Epifano. Pisano is de eerste nul. Actie 3. Dan nu aan slag de korte stop. Eric Epifano. Epifano, de 2-0 door de aangooi, 5-3. Dan nu een slag met rug nummer 1, derde honkman Leonardo Ferrini.
Tweede helft, tweede inning op het werpen van Christian Scavini. Openingslagman voor de Kingdom of the Netherlands. Ketchup, Tashenko, Ricardo. Tashenko, Ricardo, de eerste nulnullen van 7. Vito Frisia. Vervolgens aanslag linksvelder met rug nummer 12. Giandino Tromp. Mooie actie van Leonardo Verini, Renzo Martini, Giandino Tromp, de 2-0 door de aangooi 5-3. Aanslag, druk nummer 22, derde honkman, Kevin Josefina.
Biertje.
Kevin Josefina, de derde nul. Actie 3-1 brengt een einde aan de tweede inning. En we hebben voor jullie een hele speciale verrassing. Ze zitten al klaar. Graag een warm applaus voor de Blackbird Dancers.
Come on.
Two balls, two strikes on Ricardo. Brings up Vito Frisia. Hit by pitch. Brings up Alberto Minio. Are winning 2-1. We'll see what can happen in the next inning. Stay tuned. We're heading into the bottom of the third inning at the top of the lineup, starting off with Roger Bernardino. feel the air coming here. Swinging in a strike three. That brings up Coco Ballantine, designated hitter for the Kingdom of the Netherlands. Three balls, two strikes on Coco. Bases on balls for Coco. That brings up our second baseman, Charlene Strope. One out, man on first. ball strike three. We got two down. One man on. That brings up Denzel Richardson. And that ends the inning. Pop up the shortstop. We head into the top of the fourth inning with the Kingdom of the Netherlands leading Italy 2-1.
Begin inning nummer 4. Openingslagman voor Italië. De eerste honkman Renzo Martini. Renzo Martini, de eerste 0 eraan, gooi 4-3. Volgende man aanslag is rechtsvelder Noel González.
Noel González. Hij sneuvelt met 3 slag. Vervolgens aanslag. Midvelder Federico Ciani. Federico Celli, de derde nul, ook hij sneuvelde de aangooi 4-3. Einde van de eerste helft, vierde inning. Op de heuvel bij Italië ziet u nu met rug nummer 46 Matteo Bocchi. Dus nieuwe werper bij Italië met rug nummer 46 Matteo Bocchi. Christian Scafini gooide 3 volledige innings met en de cijfers 3-2-2-0. Tweede helft, vierde inning, als eerste aanslag voor de Kingdom of the Netherlands. Eerste honkman Juremy Brovar. Jeremy Prova bereikt het eerste honk door een fout 1 na 3.
De helft, tweede inning op het werpen van Christian Scavini. Openingsslagman voor de Kingdom of the Netherlands. Ketcher Dashenko.
John Polonius is de eerste nul door een van 9. In de slagperk catcher Dashenko Ricardo. Jeremy Provan is de 2-0 aan bij Stelen, actie 1 na 5. De Cinco Ricardo wordt uitgevangen door linksvelder Vito Frisian. Is hiermee de derde nul met een vang 7. Einde van de vierde inning. En dat betekent dat ze weer voor ons op gaan treden. De cheerleaders van de Blackbird Dancers.
Let's hear it for the Blackbird Dancers, ladies and gentlemen. Top of the fifth inning with a designated hitter for Italy, Dario Pisano. Did not take a swing. We got 3 balls and 2 strikes on Dario. Ball four takes his first base. That brings up shortstop for Italy, Eric Epifano. Thank you. sacrifice hit, pitcher to first base for the first out, brings up a pinch hitter. Coming in for Leonardo Ferrini is Mattia Marachini. Swing and a miss for the field. For out number two. And now we go to the top of the inning with Ricardo Perini.
Thank you.
count. Man on second, two outs. Brought in a new pitcher, Maurizio Andretta. He's replacing Matteo Bocci. Our first batter for the Dutch team is Giandini Trump, as we call him, El President. Foul ball out of play. Two balls, two strikes. Yeah. second base to first base. We got one down, bring it up. Full count for Kevin. Swing and a miss, strike three for out number two. That brings up the top of the order, our center fielder, Roger Bernardina. What a game, ladies and gentlemen. This is a close game. We are heading into the top of the sixth inning with the Netherlands leading 2-1. It is close. And we're going to ask you all kindly not to smoke in the stands. Please keep your smoking out into the parking lot. Right now, we're out to have a good time. We're watching the cheerleaders. We're having Cracker Jacks, eating hot dogs. This is a fun night, and it's good baseball, ladies and gentlemen.
Try to take me off the stairs for a ride.
Wie is gisteren geweest? Echt?
Oh.
Zijn die ze heel veel, ja. Wat komt het bij van de oude mensen lekker, hè? Zing maar mee! Nederland is Lars Huijer vervangen door de man met rug nummer 33, Kevin Kelly. Is nu op de heuvel voor Nederland met rug nummer 33, Kevin Kelly. De cijfers van Lars Huijer in 5 volledige innings, 6-2-2-0. Op het werpen van Kevin Kelly, openingslagman voor Italië, begin zesde inning, Vito Frisia. Slag voor Vito Frisia. In het slagperk catcher Alberto Mineo. Vito Frisia is de eerste nul die sneuvelt in dit schitterende dubbelspel door actie 6-4. Alberto Mineo de tweede nul eraan gooit. 4-3. Twee uit. Aanslag. Eerste honkman. Renzo Martini. Thank you. Lorenzo Martini. De derde 0, drie slag aangooien, 2 na 3. Einde van de zesde inning. Jan Schoon, de eerste 0, hij krijgt 3 slag. Volgende man aan slag, rechtsvelder, Denzel Richardson. Denzel Richardson krijgt een vrije loop. Opzettelijk vierheid. In het slagperk. Hij sloeg tot nu toe 2 uit 2. Eerste honkman, Jeremy Prova. Coco Ballantin schuift door naar de derde honk. Denzel Richardson naar de tweede honk door een wilde worp. Infield fly, John Polonius, de 2-0 door een vangzis. In het slagperk, catcher, Tashenko, Ricardo. Shevchenko Ricardo, de derde nul. Hij krijgt drie slag.
Start off the top of the seventh inning. This is the final inning for this game. Ernesto Liberatore. Full count on Ernesto.
Thank you.
Federico Celli, our center fielder for Italy. Dario Pisano, designated hitter for Italy. Safe on first base, this game is continuing. Two down, man on first, that brings up shortstop Eric Epifano. Two strikes, two outs, man on first base, top of the seventh inning. Kingdom of the Netherlands leads 2-1.
Hello.
for the players, ladies and gentlemen. They did a great game tonight. Thank you.
It is close, and we're going to ask you all kindly not to smoke in the stands, please.
We have a special announcement, ladies and gentlemen. The player of the game tonight, number 13 for the Kingdom of the Netherlands. Please give a big applause for Jeremy Papa. Two hits, two RBIs, player of the game. Thank you, Jeremy. Jeremy is going to sign two hard balls and throw them into the crowd. So two people here are going to go home with signed baseballs from Jeremy.
Een daverend applaus.